From high atop Healthcare Hill in Central Maryland, this is BSN Headline News. Today's top story is Bon Secours fiscal year has come to an end, and everybody knows what that means. Year-end reviews are coming. Indeed, some of you may have already completed your year-end review, but for others, here's what you need to know. This year, the process has been redesigned, and while the measurements have not changed, SuccessFactors is now simpler and easier to use. Oh, and updated. We had a chance to sit and chat with Tim Davis, Executive Vice President and Chief Administration Officer for Bon Secours Health System, about these changes. Let's listen in. We're here today with Tim Davis, Executive Vice President and Chief Administrative Officer for Bon Secours Health System. Tim, we've heard that the year-end performance reviews will be different this year, and we're hoping you could help us understand what that means. But first, is it true? Are year-end performance reviews different?
Yes, that's true. And I'm very excited about the enhancements that we've made this year. Our new annual review is about you, your career, your aspirations, and how you contribute to the Bon Secours ministry. The redesign will shift our conversations away from only talking about performance, which is still important, to talking more about your areas of strength and how you want to grow and develop, and how you hope to further the ministry in the new year.
Are there other changes we should know about?
Yes, there are. Thanks for asking. With the old review process, coworkers would occasionally tell us they were too busy filling out the form and not engaging in an effective conversation. We heard your feedback. One of our primary goals with the new annual review process is to give employees a great discussion with their supervisor. The annual review format has a brand new look and feel, and I think you'll find it a lot easier. This should really enable you to focus on the conversation and not the tool. There are also a number of behind-the-scenes things that have been done to enhance the SuccessFactor tool. For example, we've updated the goal library and created guidelines to simplify that part of the process. But I think if you just jump in and start using it, you'll see very quickly it's a lot easier.
So, what happens if I get stuck?
Dave, I hope you're not going to get stuck, but we have training and guides available on IRIS, and the Ask HR team is always there to assist you if you need help. But I really think you're going to find the new form so easy that you won't need any help at all. But just in case, we're here and we're ready.
Now, it's important to remember that all year-end reviews need to be completed by October the 10th. If yours isn't scheduled yet, you might want to talk to your immediate supervisor. But for your part, check out the resources and guides on IRIS on the Talent Management page. Or use the search engine on IRIS to find your specific topic. Or contact HROC, that's the Human Resources Operations Center. Numbers are on the screen. Year-end reviews are here. Time to think about your accomplishments now. In other news, Our Lady of Belfont Hospital in Ashland, Kentucky, has recently received the Get With The Guidelines / Silver Plus Quality Achievement Award. Why? Well, the American Heart Association and the American Stroke Association have specific quality improvement measures for the treatment of stroke patients, and Our Lady of Belfont Hospital has successfully implemented those quality improvement measures. This is a great honor for Bon Secours and Our Lady of Belfont Hospital and is consistent with our strategic quality plan to ensure our care is extraordinary. With this award, Our Lady of Belfont Hospital is demonstrating that our patients are receiving care based on internationally respected clinical guidelines. According to Dr. Deepak Bhatt, National Chairman of the Get With The Guidelines Steering Committee, studies have shown that hospitals that consistently follow Get With The Guidelines quality improvement measures can reduce patients' length of stays and 30-day readmissions and reduce disparity gaps in care. According to the American Heart Association, American Stroke Association, stroke is the number four cause of death and a leading cause of adult disability in the United States. On average, someone suffers a stroke every 40 seconds. Someone dies of a stroke every 4 minutes, and 795,000 people suffer a new or recurrent stroke each year. Get with the Guidelines Stroke Silver Plus Quality Achievement Award and Our Lady of Belfont Hospital. Ensuring our care is extraordinary. Finally, we've been sharing some of our greening tips and IS tips, but today we want to share with you one of our wellness tips. Here it is. So I'm just saying, colon cancer remains the third most common cancer overall. But the rates are dropping. Listen to this. Between 2000 and 2010, we saw colon cancer drop more than 3% each year. Experts point to increased awareness in screening tests, including colonoscopies, as a key factor in the trend. In fact, the percentage of Americans aged 50 to 75 who have had at least one colonoscopy jumped from 19% in 2000 to 55% in 2010. But if more Americans were to get screened, the rate would drop even more. That's where you come in. Screenings are essential for colon cancer prevention because they detect polyps or tissue growths where colon cancer starts. And screenings allow doctors to remove polyps before they can do any long-term damage. Colon cancer screenings generally begin at age 50, but because the disease has a genetic component, those with a family history of colon cancer may need to be screened earlier. Now, many say they are afraid of the discomfort associated with a colonoscopy, but I can tell you, if you ask anyone who has had colon cancer, the slight discomfort you feel from a colonoscopy is nothing by comparison. I'm just saying. More of these tips in future broadcasts, but if you'd like to use any of these videos, just let us know. Well, that's it for this week. Stay tuned to this portal for future up-to-the-minute information on these and other stories on BSN Headline News. I'm Dave Schlachter. Thanks for joining us. BSN Headline News is a production of Bon Secours Productions and is solely responsible for its content.